मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, अप टू यस्टरडे वी ऑलरेडी सी द हाउ टू ड्रॉ द लेविस स्ट्रक्चर्स, लेविस डॉट स्ट्रक्चर्स, एंड इन द लास्ट दैट इज द वीक वी सी द ऑक्टेट रूल ऑल्सो. नाउ व्हाट इज द ऑक्टेट रूल? ऑक्टेट रूल इज ऑल्सो पुट फॉर बाय लेविस एंड ही टेल्स दैट ड्यूरिंग द बॉन्ड फॉर्मेशन every atom share or give or gain electrons so that its valence shell, that is the last shell, contain 8 electrons as that of the inner gases, and then the molecule gets stabilized. But there are some limitations of octet rule. Limitation means drawback, that is the errors. Now, which are the limitation of octet rule? Now, in nature, such molecules are stable whose central atom does not complete its octet. That means its valence shell do not have 8 electrons. Still, that molecules are very stable in nature. That means octet rule fails here. So it is the limitation of octet rule or drawback of octet rule, or it is the error of octet rule. Again, in nature there are such molecules whose central atom have more than 8 electrons in the valence shell. But still that molecules are also stable in nature, as the central atom does not have only 8 electrons as that of the inert gases. They have the extra electron in the valence shell. So this is also the limitation of the octet rule. And third limitation is that some of the molecules have their central atom odd electrons, odd number of electrons. Now let us see first the such molecules which have the incomplete octet. Now see, which are such molecules which have their central atom have the incomplete octet? Now that molecules are some molecules such as boron trifluoride, BF3, beryllium dichloride. Again, some examples are there in the nature like this. Now in these molecules, their central atom, such as in BF3, boron, and in BCl2, that is the beryllium dichloride, beryllium, these atom does not complete their octet. Still, they are very, very stable in nature. They found in nature. But octet rule said what? Every atom during the formation of covalent bond completes their octet in the outermost shell valence shell as that of the inner gases. But here, these central atom does not complete their octets, but they are stable, they are found in nature. So this is the limitation of octet rule fails here. So this is the limitation or drawback of the octet rule. Which that limitation? Incomplete octet. Octet is not completed. Let us see the example first. Beryllium dichloride. In beryllium dichloride, beryllium is the central atom in that molecule, and beryllium have atomic number 4. You know that. You must remember up to the 30 atomic numbers elements by heart, and with their electronic configuration are also you must learn, and you must understand that electronic configuration. Then and then you can study or understand the next topics. The one up to 130 elements, the atomic number of that elements and the symbol of that element you must do by heart. Now beryllium, atomic number 4 is there and having the electronic configuration as 1s2 2s2. Now this 1s orbital is not the valence shell, because valence shell means outermost shell. Now beryllium have the 2 electrons in its valence shell. 2s2 here, second valence shell contain only the two valence electron. Thus there are two valence electrons in beryllium. Now see the electronic configuration of chlorine also. Chlorine have the atomic number 17. Have the electronic configuration as, you must remember the electronic configuration, very important. Chlorine have the electronic configuration 1H2, 2H2, 2P6 up to this 10 electrons, then 3H2, 12 and 3P5, 17. Now this third main shell, that is the valence shell which contains these two orbitals, that is the subshells. Now sir, these two, that is this valence shell, main shell contains how many valence electrons? 5 plus 2. Because only the valence shell electrons take part into the bond formation. Now there are the 7 valence electrons in chlorine atom. Now I show that valence electron of chlorine atom, both chlorine atom are there, both two chlorine atoms in beryllium dichloride. So both have the 7 valence electron. I show that now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 1 electron it shares with the electron of beryllium to form the bond between beryllium and chlorine in this way. Beryllium and both of the chlorine are there. Now this is the linear molecule because in a straight line 3 of the nucleus are there. So the shape of this beryllium dichloride is linear shape. Now, and the bond angle between these two bonds is 180 degree. So it is the straight molecule. Now see, in this also chlorine have the 7 valence electron. I show that by the dots. And this is the electron of beryllium. Also this is the electron because beryllium have 2 valence electrons. They take part into the bond formation. Beryllium share its both electron with the 1 electron of the chlorine atoms and form the 2 covalent bond around the beryllium. Now see here, this chlorine, first chlorine, see this is the first chlorine atom. Now these shared pair between beryllium and chlorine belongs to this chlorine atom also. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 8 electrons. Chlorine completed its octet. Another chlorine atom also completed octets because there are the 6 electrons which are the lone pairs, 3 lone pairs and these 2 electrons of the one pair. So there are the 8 electron chlorine also, that is completed octets. But what is about the beryllium? Now see, around beryllium there are only 4 electrons. This shared pair is also of beryllium, belongs to beryllium. This shared pair also belongs to beryllium. So beryllium have only the 4 electrons, not 8 electrons, 4 electrons less to complete the octet. But still this beryllium dichloride molecule is very stable. Now where is the octet rule? That means octet rule fails to explain the stability of these molecules. Though their central atom does not complete the octet, but still they are stable in nature. So this is the incomplete octet, is the limitation of the octet rule. Now come to the second example, that is the boron trichloride. Now boron trichloride, in that this molecule, boron is the central atom and boron have atomic number 5. So the electronic configuration of boron is 1H2, 2H2, 2P1. Now the valence shell, that is the second main shell, contain only 3 electrons. That is the valence electron. So I show in this figure the 3 valence electron by dots around this boron. Again there are the 3 chloride molecules. Chlorine have the electronic configuration as that of the 1H2, 2H2, 2P6, 3H2, 3P5. There are also in chlorine there are the 7 valence electron, and that 7 valence electron I show here by dots. Now the 3 lone pair and 1 electron of both chlorine atoms take part, all the 3 chlorine atoms take part in the bond formation. So chlorine, all the 3 chlorine atoms completed their octet. As in beryllium, the chlorine atom completed its constructed in the same manner. But what is about this boron? The central atom. Boron have only the 6 electrons around it, only the 6, that is the bonding pairs, because that bond pairs of electron also belongs to that of the boron. Boron does not completed its octet, it have only 6 electrons. Octet is not completed, but still this boron trichloride molecule is available in nature, and the shape of the boron trichloride molecule is in this way, that is the triangular shape as shown here. Now three bond around the boron, and this is the triangular shape, and the bond angle between this ClBCl or ClBCl, any bond angle of this is that of the 120 degree, because all the, that is the 360, and this is also the 120 degree angle, this is also 120 degree angle. Now this is exist in nature, their bond angles we can measure of ClBCl. Then what is about the stability of this molecule? How this molecule can stable? Octet rule says that only the atoms when share their electrons or transfer their electrons, only they have complete their octet. That is the octet rule. But here the central boron atom does not complete its octet. So this is also the example, boron trichloride is also the example of the incomplete octet. Here also octet rule fails. In this way, this is the first limitation of the octet rule. Let us consider now the second limitation of octet rule, that is the expanded octet. That is the expanded octet. Now what is that? Let us see. Now in the incomplete octet, we take the example of, that is the boron trichloride. You may take the example of boron trichloride. Only the atomic number of fluorine is 9. So the electronic configuration is 1H2, 2H2, 2P5. There are also the 7 electrons. You can draw the structure of boron trichloride also. Now come to the second limitation of this octet rule. That is the expanded octet. That means more than 8 electron. Expanded means. Now there are some molecules in nature such as phosphorus pentachloride, sulfur hexafluoride. Sulfur hexafluoride is also the expanded octet molecules, and phosphorus pentachloride is also the expanded octet molecule. Aluminium trichloride is also there. Now all these in the central atom of these molecules, such as phosphorus, sulfur and aluminium, they have more than 8 electrons after bond formation. Their valence shell contain more than 8 electrons. That means octet rule fails here. Because what says the octet rule? During the formation of covalent bond, every atom completes its octet in the valence shell, that is the 8 electron, as that of the inert gases. But these are the molecules, they do not have only 8 electrons, they have more electrons, such as in phosphorus pentachloride, this phosphorus have the 10 electron in its valence shell, that is more than 8 electron. Also the sulfur have the 12 electron, so that are also more than 8 electron. So what is about the stability of these molecules? Because they are very stable in nature, they found in nature, then where is the octet rule about these molecules? So octet rule fails here. This is also the limitation or drawback or error of the octet rule. Now see, phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus having atomic number 15. You must remember that. So the electronic configuration is 1H2, 2H2, 2P6 up to this 10 electron, 3H2, 12 and 3P3. That is the 15 electrons. Now this last valence shell contains 5 electrons. So this 5 electron I show here by dot of this phosphorus atom. Now see, these are the 5 electrons. They are taking part into the bond formation with that of the 5 different chlorine atoms and form the 5 bonds around it. Such as see here, phosphorus, it have the 5 bond around it, and this is the structure of phosphorus pentachloride molecule. Now here also chlorine completed their octet. The electronic configuration of chlorine is 1H2, 2H2, 2P6, 3H2, 3P5, 7 electrons. Now these 7 electrons are shown by, these are the 3 lone pairs, 6 electrons, and this is the 7th which is taking part into the bond formation. So every chlorine atom completes its octet. It satisfies the octet rule. But what is about this phosphorus? Phosphorus has more than 8 electrons around it. So this molecule does not obey in case of phosphorus the octet rule. Again see the sulfur. Sulfur have the atomic number 16. In sulfur hexafluoride, this sulfur molecule have around itself there are the 12 electrons. How are that? Now the electronic configuration of sulfur is 1H2, 2H2, 2P6, 3H2, 3P4. This last valence shell contain 6 electrons. There are the valence electrons. Now and chlorine. Chlorine have the atomic number 9. It has electronic configuration as 1H2, 2H2, 2P5. Now there are the 7 valence electrons in case of the 7 valence electrons in case of the where fluorine atom. So the 7 valence electron of these 6 fluorine atoms in the SF6. These are 6 fluorine atoms, 7 valence electrons are shown by these dots, and 1 electron which take part into the bond formation of every fluorine atom. And the 3 lone pairs are there that are shown by the dots. So there are 6 fluorine atoms around this sulfur. So the structure of sulfur hexafluoride is in this way. Now this is the structure of sulfur hexafluoride molecule. Because in SF6 there are the 6 bond around the sulfur. So every bond, you know, every bond have the 2 electron, shared pair of electron. So these 2 multiply by 6 becomes 12 electrons that are more than the 8 electrons. So this is also the example of expanded octet. Though the fluorine completes this octet, but this sulfur have the more electron. So stability of this sulfur hexafluoride molecule is not also explained by the octet rule. So this is also the drawback of the octet rule. Now this is the second drawback of octet rule. Now see that figures, and you try to draw the figures. Now see the third limitation or third drawback of this octet rule, that is the odd electron molecules. In nature there are some molecules such as nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide. Their atoms, that is nitrogen atom and oxygen atom, have the odd electron. That means not even electron or 8 electron. But they do not obey the octet rule. But still they are stable. For example, see this in the nitric oxide molecule. Nitrogen have the electronic configuration as 1H2, 2H2, 2P3. Because the atomic number is 7. Now these 5 electrons are the valence electron. They are shown here. These 3 electrons are shown, and 2 electrons are taking part into this double bond. Again, oxygen have atomic number 8. So the electronic configuration 1H2, 2H2, 2P4. Now see here, these 6 electrons in the valence shell, that is the valence electron are shown by these 2 lone pair, 4 electrons, and 2 electrons are taking part into the bond formation. Here oxygen completed its octet, because these electrons are also belong to that of oxygen. But what is about the nitrogen? See here, in this case nitrogen have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 electron. That means odd electron, not completed octet. Still this NO, that is the nitric oxide molecule, is stable in nature. Now see the another example, that is the nitrogen dioxide. Into that oxygen have the odd electrons. How it that? Now see here, nitrogen now having the configuration 1H2, 2H2, 2P3. Now these 5 electrons of nitrogens are 1, 2, 3. Again 4, its nitrogen is there, and these electrons, one of these electrons, now the 5 electrons, only the, in case of nitrogen, these 3 electrons are taking part into the bond formation. So these 3 electrons are there, 1, 2, 3 are shown here. Now about this oxygen, this oxygen, it have the 6 electrons and these 2 electrons of nitrogen, it completes it octet here. Here also oxygen have these 6 electrons of itself, this valence 6 electron, but still these 2 electrons are there which are given by that nitrogen. So nitrogen acquires the positive charge. And this oxygen have the extra electron. So oxygen have more than, that is the 6 valence electron. 1 electron is more, which is given by this nitrogen for bond formation. So here is also odd electron for oxygen, and it acquires the negative charge. Therefore, these odd electrons